Hello and welcome to the fourth video of OpenMCT for Engineers. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a basic display implementation of the telemetry points we implemented in the last video. To do so, I'm going to give you a short overview of the screen you see right here. Then we're going to create the views and plots we want, and I'm going to explain them a little. In the end, we're gonna arrange and adapt those views, so we have our first modular build display for the telemetry we've implemented. So, what do we see here? On the top left is a very important button, the create button. In here are all the creatable objects listed, and we're gonna use them soon. On the left side, we have our object tree, in which all our objects are listed. It doesn't matter if it's telemetry points or if it's the implemented objects. Here in the middle we see the main screen. Here the selected object is displayed, for example here the title screen or some telemetry data. On the right here we get some additional information about the currently displayed or selected object in the main screen. And on the bottom here we have the time control. Here we can decide whether we want to see the real-time data, here called local clock. We can adapt the field of view. For example, here now we see the last minute, and 30 seconds in the future. So we could also say, okay, show us the last 10 minutes and we will see the last 10 minutes of data. So we keep it at a minute, but you can not only view your telemetry in real time, so if you're looking at it at a later point in time, if you saved it as history for example, or if you just want to have a look at it after the flight test or whatever you're doing is completed, you can also see it in a fixed time span. So we can say, okay, show us from the 9th of November from 1:45 up to now, and this fixed time span can be viewed. We can also zoom into the time span like that, or if we have real long data we can also choose the date from which the data shall be displayed. Furthermore, on the top here we have on the right also some additional buttons. We can toggle the full screen, we can open MCT in a new browser tab. Here we can expand those items which give us some information about how many snapshots we did. You can do this here and save to notebook we create later. You can clear the data, so now the history is cleared and we will start from the beginning. You see if some timer is being followed. Here we have offline storage activated, which means the objects we create here are stored in the cookies of the browser. So if we go back to the if we open the localhost 8080 address again, we will have still have those objects. They are not stored in some server we have to access, it's stored directly here on the computer. Although you have to bear in mind, if you change from localhost to some other IP, those objects will not be in your object tree anymore, but you can export them if you select here export as JSON, and then your objects are exported and you can change your IP. This tree here will be empty and you can import them back in the same process. But you're not only bound to the option of storing your personal created objects directly on your computer, you can also share it in a server-based solution like for example CouchDB. More information to that you can find on the OpenMCT homepage of NASA. That was the overview. as we can see here, I modified the dictionary, so we have not generic points, but some nicer telemetry points which have meaning. I also added some telemetry points, and you can do that using the generator as described in the video before, or you can just copy paste here one telemetry point, alter it as you please, and then add the key to your Python script, and you're good to go. You added another telemetry point. So now we've got that sorted out, let's get started with creating our very first display. To do so, I like to create a new folder for the current project I'm on, especially if you're using OpenMCT for more than one aircraft or one telemetry generating thing. So let's call that aircraft 42 objects. So let's store it in my items, and you can see now the new folder here in my items. Next, we will create the backbone of our implementation, the empty display. For that we have three options. One free display where you have one side and you can choose from all the objects and just drag and drop them in there freely and resize them. You have the flexible layout in where you can arrange your objects in columns or rows. And you have the tabs view where you have like a browser tab, multiple tabs where you have multiple display layouts. So we're gonna start with a simple display layout, call it aircraft 42 basic display. You can add some notes describing the display. That's the grid size to which the created objects will lock, and you can define the size of the display, but you don't have to. So store it in the aircraft 42 objects. We now have our basic display. You can already add some boxes, lines, text, or images. Images are really interesting. For example, if you want to monitor some ailerons or something on an airplane, so you can put a picture of your airplane in here, or some generic airplane, and arrange the telemetry accordingly, so you know, okay, aileron left 3 has this and this value now, and you have it visually, so you can grasp and absorb the information faster. With text, line, and box, I did, for example, the title screen, so you can build whatever you like with that. We don't need that at the moment, so we're gonna save and finish edit this basic display. That's now our canvas where we can do whatever we like. For example, just drag and drop data in here, and it will be displayed in simple alphanumeric style. On the right we get some information about the telemetry. We can change the style of the telemetry. We can also use conditions to change that styling, but this will be discussed in another video. You can also change the size. You can say, okay, show me label and value, show me only label, only value. And another interesting part here is you can directly here say you want to see it alphanumeric, you want to see it as an overlay plot like this, you want to see it as a telemetry table, so it will show you like that, or just alphanumeric as we had it. Here my custom views are not visible, because I would have to change the source code, and I didn't want to change too much in the source code, so you will be able to update OpenMCT easily to the newest NASA standard. Okay, so far so good. Let's save this display and create some more stuff for the display. So let's implement a clock, so we have the UTC time always here, and we will also add a timer. You can set a target for the timer, so you can count down to some special point in time, or you just leave it blank and you have a timer on which you can start and stop and reset as you please. You can choose the display format. We will only need hours, minutes, seconds for our case, because it's an aircraft test, it won't go over days. So we have here our timer which we can start, will count up, we can stop, we can reset, and that can be very handy. Furthermore, we will create a notebook in which we can write notes during the flight test with automatically added timestamps, so that is very useful to make small notes during the test so you won't forget, and you can use it very well during debriefing. Add this. Now we have some basic tools which can be very handy while monitoring data. We can rearrange them as we please. So let's get the UTC time up here. Yes, very nice. Do some speed up rearranging. Don't display the frame on parts we don't need the frame. Drag and drop the notebook in. Rearrange a little bit. Disable the frame. Yo. So we have our little organizing part up here. So now we will add some views for the telemetry. For example, let's start with a fuel bar. The fuel bar displays a percentage between minimum and maximum value. And here we assume we have the fuel volume. So at zero, no volume was flowing through the sensor, and at 100 milliliters, for example, of fuel were running through the sensor, and the tank is empty. So our telemetry goes from 0 to 100. So at zero, it will display we have 100% fuel. At that 100, it will display 0% fuel. But if you have it implemented differently, you can also change the minimum value to a higher value than the max value. So in this case, at zero, the bar will show 0%, and at 100, the bar will show 100%. But we will have it like that, so we will use up our fuel, we add it to the basic display, and now we drag and drop our fuel flow into here, save and finish editing, and reload the page. So now we can see our telemetry goes from 0 to 100, as we can see here, it goes up, and here we see it goes down. So at 100 milliliter used, we have 0% fuel, for example. So let's continue with a gauge. It's a standard gauge. We can set its size here, but we can also change the size of the gauge after creating it. Let's do here an airspeed gauge in meters per second, add it to the basic display, then drag and drop our airspeed in there, save it, and reload. So here we got our first gauge, which indicates the airspeed. We can also change the properties of any created object, not only gauges, but also fuel bars or process bars or plots, and adding the properties afterwards. For example, if we want to have a little bigger gauge, change this to 100, reload the page, and we will have a bigger gauge. Bigger gauge. So let's create a progress bar. Progress bar shows the true value of the telemetry point given, not the percentage, and it also has ticks on the side of the bar. Let's do here a progress bar with, for example, the height above ground. The title you type in here for fuel bar, progress bar, and gauge will be the title displayed under the value. Add it also to our basic display and drag and drop the height above ground in here. Reload. So here, for example, okay, we forgot to state the unit. So we can edit the properties, height above ground in meters. All right, so it's added here. So now let's implement some standard OpenMCT plots, like the overlay plot, created also in the basic display. And let's track, for example, let's do the GPS speed and the airspeed, so we can compare those live, for example. Another standard OpenMCT plot is the stacked plot, in which the added telemetry objects will not share the same y-axis, but every telemetry object will have its own y-axis. So let's do here with the PPM, for example. Save and finish. And last but not least, we will create a last available data table, which will show us, you know, the last available data of the telemetry objects added. It's here, LED table, add to the basic display, and just put in some of the telemetry points. Let's have load factor, some telemetry points in there. And now we have added all we want to our screen, but it's all crammed in the top left corner, so we can rearrange it in the edit mode, which can be activated up here on the little pen. So let's rearrange the stuff we have to have a nice overview of our data. So now we've implemented quite quickly a fairly nice display in which we have the time, all the data we need in the style we wanted. We can stop, for example, maneuvers. We can add notes while testing. We can delete those notes. We can take screenshots to our node. You can see here, that's for the nodes. So now a little recap. I explained some basic views and plots here. In my wiki, all those creatable objects are explained in more detail, and I will also make more videos with conditional styling and using of special objects like the button or the map. So, thank you for watching and have fun implementing your own data modular in OpenMCT.